Yeah, man, a Virgo Don, the lyrical sultan, and we have lyrics like Christ, I like sand millions on top of millions to suit each and every one. Whoosh! Yeah, how did I get associated with the jungle drum and bass scene? Well, for me, it was a natural progression. I'm a dancehall artist, I'm an entertainer, I'm into music, and it's bass-driven music, so it was always going to be a natural progression for me. Furthermore, most of my friends were already in there having fun, you know, so I wanted to have some of the fun as well, innit? So, yeah, my first memories of just vibing, raving to the whole entire vibe. I always just love having big systems in my car. So what you're going to need next is music with big bass, isn't it? So especially on the weekends, I used to wait for the pirate stations to switch on. Lock into the pirate station and be driving around all weekend with them big bad bass lines just pumping out of the car. You know, furthermore, those days, most clubs, most DJs would pick out at least a few of the jungle tunes to play. So you'd be in a club and you'd hear like, you know, Leviticus Burial. Yeah, yeah, everybody go mad on the dance floor. So yeah, those are my first memories. Yeah, those are my first memories as a, like a raver. In terms of artistry, I remember Tenafly asked me to roll with him to a rave one night. Got there, I think he was in Brighton or something, and he's on stage doing his thing, and he hand me the mic, do my thing, do this thing, hand me the mic, do my thing, and we just kind of had a little vibe down there. Only for a couple of days after that, the promoter phones me up and asks to book me for the month after. At the time, I was actually on a sabbatical from music, full stop, so that was kind of like great for me, and it kind of just brought me back into music, full stop. So that was my first memory as an artist in the jungle drum and bass scene. Well, growing up in Jamaica, CB radios were very, very popular. So I needed a CB handle. So I'm a Virgo, so I called myself Kid Virgo. Natural. Yeah, so roll around with that for a little while. Decided I was going to get into the MCing thing. I was still kind of using Kid Virgo. But then when I decided to go professional with the whole entire thing, didn't really want to be calling myself Kid anymore. Furthermore, I needed a name that would rhyme, you know. Counteraction, right diversion, stay upon it long. Yeah, you know, so I decided to say, all right, Don, Virgo Don. So yes, so that's where the name came from.
Thank you.
My label name came because in high school we had a crew called the Starboy Massive, and in the Starboy Massive everyone's name had to start with S, so my name was Sultan, or the Sultan. So it was just natural moving after school, create the label, so it was the Lyrical Sultan. So that's where it came from.
Listen, I'm not just talking about being cool and so right. them to the ladies. My lips are sipping naked, like I knew this, if you're no fish. Man up in the air, I'm bossing, bossing. My wife is in the